Everything you know and love is built from atoms, and arguably the most important aspect of atoms is the way that they bond, and this is solely defined by electrons, which in turn are defined by four numbers. Four numbers to rule them all. Hi, I'm Advay, and today we are talking about quantum numbers. Or, to be more precise, spatial and angular momentum quantum numbers in electrons. These numbers are unique for each electron in an atom. They can be thought of as an individual ID or name for an electron. Take an example of an electron on a potassium atom, 4, 0, 0, 1/2. Each of these values is a quantum number. But what exactly do these mean? Let's break it down. The first number is n, the principal quantum number. In this particular case, the electron is in the fourth energy level, so n, the principal quantum number, is 4. Each of these energy levels slash shells are divided further into various subshells. The first energy level has just one subshell, with two electrons. But lower on the periodic table, like period 6 for example, the sixth energy level can be divided into up to 4 different subshells, with a total of 32 electrons in the shell. This is where the second quantum number, L, the Azimuthal quantum number, comes in. This tells us which subshell an electron is in. The value of L can range from 0 to n minus 1. A value of 0 means the electron is in the S subshell. A value of 1 means the electron is in the P subshell. 2 means the D subshell, and 3 is the F subshell. Since the Azimuthal quantum number in this electron is 0, we know that it is an S subshell. Each subshell is then further divided into orbitals, bringing us to the third quantum number, ML, or the magnetic quantum number. The magnetic quantum number tells us which orbital an electron is in. Its values can range from minus L to plus L. So, for an example, if an electron in the S subshell, the values of minus L to plus L are minus 0 to plus 0. Since this is just 0, we know that ML, the magnetic quantum number, has to be equal to 0. Now, we know that the four quantum numbers are unique for each electron in an atom, and each orbital can only hold 2 electrons. So, how do we differentiate between each electron in an orbital? It's simple. All electrons have a spin value. A spin value can be either half or minus half. The fourth quantum number, MS, the spin projection quantum number, takes care of this value. The value in this case is half and not minus half because it's the first electron in its orbital. While technically this could be both half or minus half as the value is randomly determined, we usually use half as the value for the first electron in orbit simply because it's simpler. Alright, now that you know about the quantum numbers, let's try out another electron. Here's an atom of bromine. Let's pick an electron. Let's also assign values to its pair to make it more straightforward for us to find the electron's numbers. The electron is on the second energy level, so n, its principal quantum number, is 2. Now L, its Azimuthal quantum number, can be between 0 and n minus 1. As n is 2, it's either 0 or 1, which means the electron is in either the S shell or the P shell. Since its a pair is in the P shell, it too must be in the P with a value of 1. Now, ML, the magnetic quantum number. As I said before, it's minus L to plus L, giving us a range of minus 1 to plus 1. There is no way of knowing which orbital the electron is in using Bohr's model of the atom, which is why having the pair's value really cleans things up. As the pair's magnetic quantum value is minus 1, our electron's magnetic quantum value will also be minus 1. And finally, the spin. Because each electron has to have a completely unique ID, this cannot be the same for the pair and our electron, giving our electron a value of half. So there we have it. Our electron is 2, 1, minus 1, half. Lastly and most importantly, I want to thank Ansh Nanda, Arkin Sachdev and Karthik Jorabar for their extremely detailed feedback for the first few videos. Thank you guys so much for taking out the time to analyze our videos so thoroughly. We really appreciate it a lot. I hope we can incorporate all of your suggestions to become better than ever. If any of you guys watching this have anything to say, positive or negative, we'd love it if you could drop a comment down below. Hey, we hope you found this video fun slash informative slash useful. If you want more cool content, click up here to watch a video randomly chosen by YouTube's algorithm. If you want to subscribe, click up here. We'll see you in the next video, but until then, good night, sleep tight, and don't let the C-mix let hilarious bite.